Prime Minister Christopher Luxon has asked for patience as thousands of people turned out across the motu this morning for the first National Day of Action organised by Te Pāti Māori. They're warning the new government they'll have a fight on their hands over policies that affect the Treaty of Waitangi. The action aligning with the opening of Parliament today as MPs swear allegiance to the King. We'll have more on that soon, but first, Jessica Swan takes us through today's events.
In more than a dozen locations across the country, people united in a common cause.
It's the right thing to do at this point in time, at this crossroads.
When you feel strongly about something, you turn up.
I guess it's scary for most of us Māori.
Watching all of those proposals is pretty worrying for us. And yeah, just showing up today, we want to represent the young people, young Māori.
Thousands turned out from early this morning.
Short notice. We said set your alarms, get out here and look at this, it's amazing. This is only the beginning of many, many protests and many, many things that are going to be happening in the next 3 years, so look out.
Te Pāti Māori says today's kaupapa was about asserting the mana of Te Tiriti o Waitangi and protecting mokopuna.
This is to send a clear message to the government that we will not tolerate their racist policies, that we are deeply concerned and outraged in terms of the legislative program rolling back all of the achievements that our leaders have worked hard to in the last 51 years.
In the capital, the group marched to Parliament before speeches were made by party co-leaders. In other spots, major disruption was caused to many commuters. These shots show the northern motorway brought to a halt. The protests were peaceful with no arrests made, and scenes like these are likely to repeat.
What happens if the government doesn't listen?
Oh, it doesn't matter whether the government listens or not. Our people are activated, our people are ready, and our people will continue to fight.
This movement will only get bigger, and voices will get louder, and it will affect this country. It's the whittle that we've been put out to not only the people in Parliament, but to people all across the country, okay, to start becoming more Te Tiriti literate.
A group is gathering in Christchurch tonight, with organisers across the motu clear, this round of action is just the beginning. Jessica Swan, One News.
The protest this morning was purposefully timed on the same day members of Parliament are sworn in and pledging allegiance to King Charles. Abby Wakefield has been watching the processions. Abby, what more can you tell us?
Good afternoon, Chris. Well, it's a very ceremonious day here as Parliament begins its official opening. There was a big red carpet rolled out on the front steps of Parliament, and what happened was there was a procession that marched from that red carpet all the way through to the Grand Hall. And a waiata was sung during that procession, and once they got to the debating chamber, MPs were there waiting for them. Now, what happened after that was MPs then swore allegiance, and the layout of the debating chamber also looks very different. If you know the debating chamber well, for the last Parliament, Labor was on that side and then National was on that side. Now that's completely switched, and Christopher Luxon now sits in the seat where former Prime Minister Chris Hipkins used to sit. Now we just saw the swearing-in of the MPs, and when it comes to the swearing-in, some parties like to do it a little bit differently. For instance, Te Pāti Māori decided to swear allegiance to the Treaty of Waitangi. Here's what happened just moments ago.
I swear that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to our mokopuna. According to tikanga Māori, I will perform my duties and functions and exercise my powers in accordance with Te Tiriti o Waitangi.
Now, also part of the proceedings today is the election of Speaker. That's expected to be National MP Gerry Brownlee with the backing of the Coalition Government. Once that happens, there is an official ceremony at Government House to confirm it this afternoon. So it's just all part of a very busy day here in the capital.
Thanks, Abby. Abby Wakefield, live for us at Parliament this afternoon.